High school chemistry teacher dropout here. Gonna show you how to make a basic beanie. This is just beginner. You just got your knitting machine. Super fun, super easy. You'll be fine. A couple things I like for beanies. Lion Brand Heartland yarn. Super nice. They have a nice, it just really does well with the Addi King. Joann's Big Twist. It's a good one. Hobby Lobby also works well. I struggle. Anything Red Heart. Struggle. There's just some kind of plasticky kind of feeling, and the Addi King just doesn't like it. So, goodbye. I do have clamps in between my handle, which you can see right here. So the clamps just keep those gears lining up because I like to use a drill. And I got this one Amazon. Works great. It's not too heavy. The adapter, Etsy. I will also have my 3D printer guy print some out. So that'll be in my store as well. And my store is West Coast Wicked. Okay, so I'm going to zoom in just a tiny bit so you can see how to thread it. Okay, so you do want to find your first black. There it is. Set your counter to 0. Okay, we're good to go. And I have a bucket. You can see the orange. And I just drop my yarn down there. And it just stays out of the way. And I'm pretty happy with it there. Right now I have yarn everywhere. It's fine. Okay, so not super long tail. I just, you know, that's fine. Don't need to be exact. And so you're going to start with that first black and you're just going to hook it under. And then as you crank, you're just going to go in and out. And you do this all the way around. Okay, so now we're back at that first black. So you're going to open up your guide, place your yarn in there, shut it. And when you have those plasticky kind of yarns, which are really cute, but they just fight with me all the time, they tend to split when you go on the second round. The finer yarns tend to split as well, but this one should be fine. So the first one, you'll feel like a little tug. And you just keep going, and it's just going to grab. Oh, see, it just split right there. So watch it. You don't want it to split, because when you go to cinch your beanie, it won't. So nice and slow. If you want a really easy yarn for the Addi King, my top two are Big Twist. And I love this yarn. Like butter through it. But this one's really cute, so. Okay, so you have two now, two rows. And I usually do a couple to get it going before I start my drill. And I'm not going super fast. I do hold it. You're gonna see my witch thumb, but I do give it a little tension. Not a ton, and certain yarns will want a little more, and you'll get the feel of it. And so my beanies, if it's just a regular slouchy kind of beanie, I do 110 rows. That just turns out perfect for me. It's what I like. I've tried many. If you want to do a foldable brim, I usually go big and I go about 150. If you're adding a palm, you can do a palm with 110, but you definitely, there's a lot extra, so I do a palm with the 150s. But you don't have to. It'll just be slouchy one that folds. Okay, so I usually don't even go this far, maybe 5 rows. Right on the handle. And then I still hold it, a little tension, and then you just start spinning. So one thing I don't like about this yarn, yeah, and it just makes me crazy, but okay, I'll be right back. Okay, 20 minutes later, I end up making a cake because it sucks so badly, but here you go. So I did have to cut it, and this is a good example of what to do changing colors. So we'll just do that. Yay. All right, so I'm just going to crank until I have about, I don't know, 4 inches or so left. And this is how I join a color. All right, maybe more. I'm gonna get closer. Okay, so I'm just gonna drop this here. And then grab the new stuff. And I just put it down just like that. So you got one on this side. And kind of just cross it over. Just lay it there. Doesn't have to be super long. Don't be crazy. And then I hold it. I make sure this one's down over it. And I'm just going to crank a couple times. Around. With my hand crank. Not the drill. And I don't tie it, so there was a knot here. I just kept going because I don't care. I give it a couple rows, otherwise it kind of puckers weird. So this is what I do. I absolutely love hand cranking. Never. But here I am. That's enough. So like I said, this is a knot in it already. I just kept going. So I'll just make that the inside. That's the beauty of beanies. So I just do a knot. Not crazy tight. Like you just want to secure it. And when I get it off the loom, I will make it a little tighter. Okay. And we're going to try and continue on. Okay, so now you had change color. So you could just change your color. You could do 15 different colors. How much fun would that be? Maybe I'll just do a lesson on changing colors. Yay. All right, here we go. Finally, normally a beanie takes about 5 minutes to spin, but because I had yarn issues, it's been more like 20 minutes, but okay. So I'm going to get to my first black, and that'll get me right at 110 rows. And there I am. So there's two methods to taking this off the little loom. I used to do the waist yarn around it. And that's good if you're doing a bunch of these at one time and you have someone that wants to sew these all up. Cool. But if you don't, skip all that. So you're going to take probably, I don't know, this do 2 feet of yarn. Cut it. You're going to open up this, take it out, and then you're going to go forward. And your loom comes with your little needle. So we're going to use that and just take it out that way, and you'll be so happy. Okay, so we're starting here. Go the next one over. So you're just going to go right in there and pick it up. And I put my finger on the one next to it so it doesn't pop off. And in the beginning, I do just one at a time. But once you get around a little bit, then you can start to do more than one. So let's do a couple more. Honestly, with my witch finger, I think I'm going to see how many videos I can make just to document how bad it looks. Look at that. Gross. Okay, we're off the loom, and now you're like, now what? So we just want to take it out. And you've got your nice little tube. Give it a little stretch. Looks good. And then I look for, you know, one side is better than the other. And you can see, you kind of see a line here. And that's that part I told you I had a knot and I just left it. So that's going to be the inside. So for me, that's easy to figure out. And if you didn't split any of your yarn, this will cinch up oh so nicely. But if you split your yarn, forget it. You're going to be so angry. Okay, you just reach in and you want to grab that and bring it to the other side. And this basic little beanie is how I make my pumpkins as well. And I have a video on that. Super easy. I've seen so many different ways, which are all great. But man, I'm just too lazy. So this is fast. Okay, so I just cinched it up. See, and I got this long old tail. Cut some of it off. I don't need all that. And I usually secure it, so I'm just going to go ahead and attach it. So we've got this, and I'm just going to go in here. You want to see. And you see the little circle here. I'm just going to go through. And it doesn't have to be pretty. No one is going to see this. And I just go all the way around and grab it, like, 4 spots. More than enough. And then I just tie a basic knot. So, knot. Perfect! That's all you need. Okay, so you grab your other string and cinch it, and we had no breaks. Yay! And this one I try to make sure it's a little nicer. So you still got your one and you got this one way too long. So you want to make sure this one is nice and taut. It's right up to it. Look how cute that is. Just spider on it. Oh, yes. Okay, maybe not. So on this one, I don't have to do much. I'm just going to tie a knot. So I have my two. I've got them nice and tight together. It looks good. And I'm just going to tie a knot. Perfect, right? That makes me so happy. So I tied it twice. And I'm usually good right here. You could do more sometimes in the beginning. I would do like more stitches, but it's good. And you can use this part right here to tie a palm to it. Or if not, let's say this one is a no palm. Let's just go ahead and do that. I'm going to cut them down a little bit. And now you're just going to hide it. If you did want to give it a little secure, you can still just go over once here and tie another knot and you'll be good, but you really don't need to. Just here. Now everyone's happy. It's not going anywhere. Okay, so you're going to put it back on the needle. And now we're going to hide it in between the layers. So we've got two layers, right? And this is like magic. So you just go in between. Keep going. And I just work it down a little bit. It doesn't have to be far. And you're only going down one layer. You're not getting both layers. And pull it. And then when you cut it, you're like, oh no, there's a tail, but you just stretch it, it's gone. And do the same for this one. I've watched a lot of videos on this, and I think this was the biggest part. It's like, I didn't know what to do afterwards. And I just figured it out. Super easy. What happened there? All right, it's fine. Stretch it and it disappears. Okay, maybe. There it is. Super cute. Stretch a little more. And this is Lion Brand Heartland. In like, I don't know what color, kind of pink. I got mad and threw the label away, so. And you can add your little tags to it, which I don't have in front of me, but, or not, or just perfect. It's a nice little stretchy, slouchy beanie. Hope you like this. Thanks for watching. See you next time.